Frank Lloyd Wright's born in 1867, dies in 1959. His career goes from 2 years after the Civil War to 2 years after the launch of Sputnik. And over the course of a 7-decade career, he embraces every innovation that comes along. And he goes on to revolutionize the world as someone that fundamentally changes the way we think about shelter and the way we live in relationship to the world around us. He returns to the native soil of Wisconsin, where he grew up, where his family had settled in the mid-19th century when they emigrated from Wales. Taliesin, in turn, becomes the full embodiment of his earliest ideas about organic architecture. The entire surrounding landscape is captured in these broad ribbons of windows, this marvelous, amazing view of the countryside. As he's going back and forth between Los Angeles and Wisconsin and also Japan, he has occasion to stop in Arizona.
They embarked to go to the state land office and ask if there was any land available for sale. The answer was, yes, I have this piece of land that I've been waiting for some fool to come along and fall in love with it. And Mr. Wright immediately thought, that's got to be me.
And from the ground itself, the stones, the sand that he finds here at the desert, he begins to construct Taliesin West. Wright creates the foundation that bears his name in 1940. He endows the foundation with these two living monuments to his work and his ideas, Taliesin and Taliesin West.
There's a really obvious connection between the built world and the natural world here at Taliesin West. The Frank Lloyd Wright Foundation inspires people to discover and embrace an architecture for better living through meaningful connections to nature, the arts, and each other.
The two Taliesins really represent the sum total of his life and the living work. During his life, Wright was constantly changing them. And that makes their maintenance, their upkeep, their preservation something that is difficult to undertake, something that's expensive to undertake.
A way that anyone can engage with us is to help support our work now and for what we envision for the future. Members and supporters are the legacy of the Frank Lloyd Wright Foundation.
The second area where we really need the public support is for our educational programs. We live in a world where questions about sustainability that Wright explored in his time have become more relevant to our ability to live well.
It's connection to everything. It's connection to life. It's connection to hope. It's connection to creativity, inspiration.
We know that the impact of Wright's principles taken in the world today in design and build and in even educational programs make us happier and healthier people.
The Frank Lloyd Wright Foundation is now poised to live up to the need and the strength of its inherited message. And we should all be supportive and very grateful for that.